Hi, welcome to our latest Bitrise update. I'm Anna. iOS code signing is difficult. That's why we've been automating it for forever. Why would you use automatic code signing on Bitrise? Well, it helps you make sure your app's FID registration is done and your build has and will use the required provisioning profiles for the archive generation and for IPA export as well. Your provisioning profiles will contain all the necessary Apple entitlements, and all the iOS tvOS test devices registered on Bitrise are registered on the Apple Developer Portal as well, so your testers can test your app on their devices. And it will save you some time and money and some major headaches. On Bitrise, there are two ways you can do automatic code signing asset management. One, using the latest versions of these steps. Connect your Apple developer account to Bitrise and enable the automatic code signing in these steps by choosing either API key or Apple ID instead of off. These steps will handle the code signing just like the old iOS auto provision step did before. Oh, that reminds you? Yup, there was another step needed for provisioning profiles. What's with that? We merged these steps into the new versions, and you can just delete them once you update the steps to their latest versions. Now let's talk about the second way you can do automatic code signing asset management. That is by adding the Manage iOS Code Signing step to your workflow. If you don't want to use any of the three steps mentioned before, replace the two old iOS auto provision steps with the new Manage iOS Code Signing step. This step can handle the Bitrise Apple Service Connection either with Apple ID or with the App Store Connect API key, so no more figuring out what to do with the old iOS auto provision steps. And finally, what's under the hood? Apple introduced Xcode automatic signing via Xcode Build in headless environments in Xcode 13+. The three Bitrise Xcode Build Archive steps utilize this feature too, along with Apple ID and App Store Connect API. Bitrise figures out the best solution for your project depending on multiple factors, like your project settings, the selected Bitrise Apple Service Connection, Xcode version, and so on. You don't need to do anything else, just select the Bitrise Apple Service Connection you prefer to use, and you are done. Happy building!